from Czech Republic. My father, he is New Session side of gypsies, and my mother's side are all workers. In Czech Republic, we was living in a small garden cottage. It's really one room. You cook on the fire and no electrician. We had outside lots of fruit trees, and you go through some racism, yeah, like calling me gypsy, not name, just gypsy come here. The worst part of it was I had to fight. And I never know from which side I will be attacked. I got pretty serious hits, like, you know, in the head, in my body, yeah. But after when I was like 14, 15, I really got seriously. I stand up for myself. We come up here to Ireland because we could work here, you know. In the time, Ireland was good, in 2004.
My name is Urs Wenk and I'm from Switzerland and I've moved here 10 years ago. My wife's Irish, so that's what brought me here. Grew up in the countryside, in a house that used to be an old farmhouse with a little milk hut, as we call it, next door, where all the farmers come in the evening, bring their milk. We get the fresh milk there and yogurts and cheese, and it's a big assembly point every night or every evening. My father used to work for the railways. My mother did all kinds of jobs, so we would get by. She was working in a nearby restaurant as a waitress. Then she'd run over to the butcher and work behind the desk in a butcher shop.
My name is Bridget Flannery. I'm from North Donegal originally. I have two brothers and a sister. We lived about 10 minutes from the pier where all of the fishing boats would be. It's on Loch Foyle, so Greencastle itself is quite a big fishing port. It's the second biggest in Donegal. Like every day you'd look out the window, there was like big boats going up with coal and deliveries, you know. It was quite a hustle and bustle little place. It only had two shops and one bar, and but there was always, you know, lots of lorries and boats coming in from other parts of the country. So there was always a good bit of life. There was a lot of foreign, you know, fishing boats, and there was always strangers in the little village. We went to school about 20 minutes from Greencastle. And so every evening, you know, you'd walk down to the pier, and we had a lovely football pitch just beside the pier. So you just hang out there. We had a youth club to go to and lots of friends. We lived in a park, a kind of a housing estate, and there was 12 houses in the estate. And I think around my age, well, I had three cousins exactly the same age, three girls. So you always had plenty of friends and to go out and just to walk to the village and stuff, so it was good.
My name is Mary McCarthy and I am from Dublin, a place called Drumcondra, which is on the north side of Dublin. I came to Dingle after spending, I suppose, the best part of 10 years travelling and living abroad, and I came down to visit my brother in February of 1992. We would spend our summers in Rush, which is a little fishing village in North County Dublin, and I would spend all year waiting to go down there because it was just freedom and a beautiful place to be, and the memories we had as kids, you know, going down to Rush and that freedom and just being able to walk along the beach and even in the rain.
My name is Larry, and I come from a defunct family. I guess that's how you'd say it, you know. I have two older sisters. One of our biggest meals was a piece of toast with tomato soup on top. So it was like something solid to eat. We got money from the church and stuff to survive. My father, he worked on the ore boats up in the Great Lakes, and he was never home. My mother finally had enough, and she just packed up the kids and moved south Michigan to a small town in Howell, Michigan. I always called her Mana, never called her mother. And she always said, "You can call me Mana. You don't have to call me mother," you know. So we had a special relationship. We were more like friends. And she knew that I wanted to smoke. She smoked. Then later on, you know, did acid and mescaline, mushrooms, mind-altering, hallucinogenic drugs. When I was around 11 years old, she finally had her nervous breakdown, and then we were sent off to live with a father who didn't want us, and sent back and lived with relatives. Then she came out of the hospital. We lived with her again for about a year, and then she had another nervous breakdown. Sister went to girls' home. My sister ended up homeless. She went to at Flannery State Hospital. Told at 15 years old, she was told she'd be there the rest of her life. I went into a relative's home for a year, and that was the beginning of my beginning.